Art and science, starting with dish vortex. Here an air core vortex is generated within a shallow stainless steel dish. Water rises and falls within this dish in a cycle of water activity. This piece was conceived for the Annick Garden as safe and easy for children to observe a vortex and interact with it. I've watched visitors, both young and old, drawn to this piece, seemingly transfixed and mesmerised for long periods of time, observing its transformations. For example, as water reaches the top, it suddenly becomes becalmed, whereas in the earlier stages it was turbulent, making extraordinary shapes. As the level drops, the body of water seems to take on a life of its own, increasingly rocking and swaying as its volume diminishes, unaided by any outside force. For years, I've listened to artists and journalists banging on about the relationship of art with science, as if the discovery that the disciplines are in many respects one and the same comes as some sort of revelation. I've always been aware of the closeness of this relationship. Of course, I acknowledge that the outcome of scientific research and the use to which it is put is largely very different from that of art, but the processes and disciplines are basically the same. My work as a sculptor is driven by research and development, by empirical experiment aimed at finding out more about what I'm doing and hopefully to discover something new. The molecular biologist or the astrophysicist is doing very much the same thing. I've recently been collaborating with a French astrophysicist called Thierry Foglitzo, who works at the Astrophysics Centre in Saclay near Paris. Thierry approached me as he saw extraordinary parallels between what he is doing and my own experiments that he had seen on YouTube. He observes that equations which describe how pressure waves are propagated in a burning gas falling into the gravitational field of a star are the same as those which dictate the behaviour of water cascading into a hole. When he filmed the swirlings of a fountain, he witnessed the same as me, the start of an instability which progressed and increased, providing a perfect analogue for a shock wave which, according to computer models, is created when a star suddenly contracts. The aesthetic spin-off of much scientific research is manifest in the sheer beauty of imagery that derives from calculation and research. Thierry hopes that his researches will throw light on the end of the story, the final contraction of the supernovae, and the birth of neutron stars.